The explosive sexual harassment allegations facing Republican congressional candidate Carl DeMaio just weeks before the election have protesters planning to come out of the woodwork tomorrow.
Just 2 hours ago, they sent us this release planning to picket a fundraiser in Pacific Beach where House Speaker John Boehner will be the featured guest. 10 News reporter Rachel Bianco first brought you the allegations at 5, 6, and 7 from a former campaign staffer. And Rachel, you spoke to a political analyst tonight who says this scandal could be a game changer.
Yeah, you're right, Kimberly. A member of the Democratic National Committee is organizing that protest scheduled for tomorrow. We're just outside of DeMaio's campaign office. He is denying all of the allegations, but with such a tight race, this scandal could sway the undecided voters against him.
Congress and take a new approach to solving it.
It's one of the closest and most high-profile races in the country. Carl DeMaio and Scott Peters are in a virtual dead heat in the fight for the 52nd Congressional District.
It is so hard fought. They took the gloves off long ago. Now they have on the brass knuckles.
Political consultant John Dadian is referring to the allegations made against DeMaio from a former campaign worker just weeks before the election. This latest twist made national headlines during this interview with CNN. Todd Bosnich says DeMaio repeatedly made unwanted sexual advances towards him.
I just was shocked because I've never had anyone do something like that to me, especially in a position of authority and trust.
Bosnich says after he confronted DeMaio, he was fired and offered $50,000 to keep quiet.
He says that, you know, you were inappropriate in the office, that you would touch him, kiss him, grab his butt.
None of it
grabbed
true.
DeMaio says Bosnich was let go for plagiarism. He was also a suspect in the break-in at DeMaio's campaign office back in May.
And so some people are wondering if the district attorney has to recuse herself from the case because she has supported Carl DeMaio in the past.
San Diego's former Democratic chairman is among them. Jester Fee sent this letter to the state attorney general asking her to take over the investigation into the break-in and the sexual harassment allegations. Both Bosnich and DeMaio's campaign manager say that they took lie detector tests. Both say they were found to be telling the truth when questioned about the allegations. Now, 10 News has not independently verified these claims, but you can count on us to stay on top of the story. And of course, we will be at tomorrow's protest. Reporting live in Mira Mesa, Rachel Bianco, 10 News.
A reminder, you can see yesterday's testy debate between DeMaio and Scott Peters tomorrow night at 9 o'clock here on ABC 10, right after NASCAR and a special edition of 10 News.